Before I proceed, if for some reason you have skipped ahead to this video and neglected to watch the lessons on inheritance and interfaces, then you need to go back and watch those videos. I have prepared all lessons in this course to follow the most logical progression I could manage, and this lesson on abstract classes will only make sense if you understood the main ideas of those videos. I am referring to the difference between sharing behavior and implementation, which have very specific meanings. There is also the main idea behind abstraction, which I explored in the first lesson of Part 4. For those who have dutifully followed along with these lessons in order, I have some very good news. I will only need to spend a moment of time explaining theory, and after that we can get straight into practical examples. We saw that inheritance, via the extends keyword, allows us to share implementation, and implementing an interface, via the implements keyword, allows us to share behavior. Both tools will allow some degree of abstraction relative to how many details they share. A limitation of interfaces is that you may not share variables. A limitation of classical inheritance is that you may not define abstract methods. Abstract classes are simply a tool which will allow you to share both behavior and implementation. If you have ever wondered when to use them, well, you now know. If you have a problem that can be elegantly solved by sharing both behavior and implementation, then an abstract class is very likely the best solution. We are now going to build part of an abstract class that comes from an actual problem in an actual application I built in the past. The very first full Java application I built was a workout logging tool. Please open up the class called Exercise Starter in Part 4, Lesson 4 of the demo source code. Also, please follow along in your preferred editor using that file as a starting point. As you can see, I have started us out with some basic variables common to different kinds of exercises. As a reminder, the protected access modifier allows visibility within subclasses. The problem we need to solve is fairly straightforward. Our behavior is that we want to be able to print out the data for a given exercise session in a nicely formatted way. However, to avoid confusion, we need to change the implementation of this behavior to account for different kinds of exercises. Here's an obvious but good general rule for creating an abstract class. Whatever changes across subclasses, make it an abstract method. Whatever stays the same across subclasses, implement it in the abstract class. First, let us add the abstract keyword to our class declaration. Next, we will write a method to get the formatted data of an exercise. A good option for building longer strings is to use the String Builder class. Every exercise output begins with a name, so we can start by appending that name to our String Builder and adding a new line character as well. At this point, our output changes, so this is where we need to perform our abstraction. I could return a string from our abstract method, but since SB is an object, we can also pass it into the receiving method and just keep appending to that same object. If that seems confusing at all, revisit section 3, the lesson on pass by value. In case you are wondering, the word set is referring to exercise terminology in this case. While we are here, let us finish off this implementation. When we are done with our string builder, we use the toString method. I'm going to let my IDE generate a new method. That is all we need to do here. Next, we will implement a child of our abstract class. Go ahead and open up barbellexercise.java in the demo source code. We will not be implementing every kind of exercise, but we will implement this one. Since abstract classes are a form of inheritance, we use the extends keyword just like a regular class. Now that we have specified the parent class, my IDE is complaining that it does not implement the abstract method defined in the parent. I will fix that by clicking on the red underlined text, hitting Alt-Enter, and then Enter. Again, Java is a terribly verbose language, so I will let my IDE do the heavy lifting by using Alt-Enter again. Now all that is left is to implement our abstract method. Every time a set of a given exercise is complete, we record the time or number of repetitions and the weight of each set in the repetitions or time array and the weight array, respectively. Now, I did not actually just use two arrays to represent a set in the real app, so understand that this is a simplified version. In any case, we need to loop through each set and print the data appropriately. Keeping in mind our desired output, we will start by appending the number of repetitions or time at the current index. Next, a space. Next, a static constant string inherited from the abstract class. An at symbol with spaces. The weight at the current index. Another string constant. And finally, a newline character. That is all we need to do. Remember, the string builder object is from the abstract class implementation, so we do not need to return anything. Also within these sources, you will find a main method within abstractclasses.java which I would like you to fix up and execute. I have also included a complete version of abstract exercise in case you get stuck, but you can use whatever you like. As promised, I wanted to end this section by giving you a quick reference guide to knowing when to use each of the three tools we have learned about here. To make it practical, I will phrase things in the form of simple questions you can ask when you face a problem that might be solved using them. I want a set of classes to share implementation. Use classical inheritance. I want a set of classes to share behavior. Use an interface. I want a set of classes to share behavior and implementation. Use an abstract class.